be the happiest moment in your life? For me, it is when my idea becomes reality. I have been a barista for 20 years, and now I can say that my ideal era has finally come into reality. My idea is to intentionally craft every drink in the most balanced way. Today, I want to share my idea through espresso, milk lunch, and signature lunch. That is, okay, ready? Let's go! I have two coffees for you. One, my classic favorite for a long time. Geisha from Finca de Bora, Panama. Because it can give such an elegant tactile as a smooth mouthfeel. As this love is washed process. I can also achieve clear, floral aftertaste. Then, my new favorite, Katura, from Finca Miras, Colombia. It has expressive flavor of star fruits. Because it's intentionally fermented. Espresso. My idea is to achieve perfect balance between tactile and flavors. I'm chilling the spout for all of my shots to maintain elegant tactile. I'm dosing 16 grams of geisha, 2 grams of katura. Extracting 46 grams size. My geisha creates amazing smooth muscle. And flora aftertaste. My katura enhances fruity flavors. When I serve you espresso, please evaluate the cream, but don't drink it yet. Please wait for my instruction. Please wait my instruction. So your taste experience, maybe? Please write down. Rock medium citric acidity. Medium sweetness. And low bitterness. Flavors of peach. Orange. Jasmine. Medium. Low to medium weight. Smooth mouthfeel. And jasmine tea finish. Now, please 5 times stir. And go ahead. Enjoy. How was your espresso? You got? Okay, thank you. I love the balance between floral tactile and fruity flavors. Let me tell you more about these coffees. Geisha from Hinkadebora is very special because the producer journey so carefully processed it and that one extra step. After washing and drying for 15 days, his geisha was rested for another 3 months so that the density is stabilized. This is the secret of his geisha's amazing tactile. Then, Katura from Finca Milan, which is very fruity. The producer, Andres, is a specialist in intentional fermentation. He placed his cherries into tank with must, fermenting in anaerobic condition together with bacteria. After that, he applied yeast into the tank to boost strong fruit flavors. For milk delights, my idea is to have milk and especially harmony. This time, I'm dosing 17 grams of Katura, 2 grams of Geisha, extracting 44 grams out. My Katura brings expressive flavors. My Geisha keeps clean and floral after effects. This makes powerful expression. The standard even is sweet milk. To pair with them, I make my milk with a 1-2-2 ratio of rice milk and lactose-free cow milk. Rice milk has no fat, but gives this silky texture. Because the rice is milled into tiny pieces and then mixed with water. And lactose-free cow milk gives great sweetness. When extracting my espresso, I use tea strainer to make a finer crema, allowing wonderful harmony for my milk device. And also, when I steam it cooler than usual, around 51 degrees, your milk device will have heavy, yet silky texture. Each cup will have 80 grams of milk for the best harmony. Just a moment. Flavors of yellow peach, orange, and honey, silky texture, and yellow flower finish, like Osmanthus cluster. Enjoy. Let me tell you about roasting these coffees. Geisha was applied with low energy to last longer. To achieve bigger body and elegant aspect. On the other hand, Katura was applied with high energy to roast lively flavors. Enjoy. Thank you for waiting. Enjoy this harmony in my milk beverage. So thank you for waiting. Enjoy. Today's final cards. For signature Vivalet,
my idea is to combine both Geisha
and Katura in
synergy. This time I'm dosing 17 grams of Katura, 2 grams of Geisha, extracting 40 grams out.
Once again, powerful special.
My Katura highlights strong fruit flavors in my drink.
My Geisha highlights elegant tactile, just the way I like. I call it
Takas.
Intentional Negroni.
I thought of Negroni as inspiration because you can taste
well balanced complexity in this drink.
Negroni normally made with gin, Campari,
and vermouth.
My first ingredient is a hard distillation
representing gin. One part rose petal,
supporting floral notes.
One part juniper arts. One part pine leaves,
supporting citrus notes.
One part juniper berry,
as used in gin. I distill them all together for one day, adding 20 grams of this distillation to my coffee, create a new note of sage.
My second ingredient is a citrus fermentation representing Campari.
One part pineapple, supporting citrus note.
One part water,
and one part
brown sugar.
For 3 days, in the anaerobic condition, adding 60 grams of this fermentation transforms the note of orange into black orange.
My third ingredient is a geisha infusion representing vermouth.
In a sous vide bag, I put in 1 part coarse ground geisha, 10 parts water, together with vanilla bean, giving caramel sweetness like vermouth. I cook them at 60 degrees for 2 hours.
By adding 5 grams of this infusion per glass just before you drink it, the floral aftertaste gets sweeter. It becomes Ceylon tea.
This also creates a different mouthfeel experience in your first and second sip there. And finally, my 4-hour shot of espresso.
This is a cold drink.
You can enjoy in 2 sips.
Each sip comes in a complex, yet beautiful balance way. This is the synergy of my Katura and Geisha.
Judges, please take a sip of water right now to refresh your palate with your signature beverage.
Thank you so much.
Your taste experience will be, please write down. First sip, sage. White peach, juicy mouthfeel, caramel finish. Second sip, black orange, apricot, silky mouthfeel, Ceylon tea finish. When I serve it to you, please don't drink it. Only after I say hi.
Just a moment. Just a moment. Just a moment.
So, judges, as I reflect on my barista journey for the last 20 years, I'm overwhelmed with joy. There are so many diverse coffees available in our specialty coffee world today. And now, I can intentionally craft my ideal drinks in the most balanced way. This is my happiest moment. Now, no need to stare. Please enjoy. Thank you, everyone. Time.